So, you know, I gotta ask you, girl, what was up with them sheets? What was up with the sheets? I'm like, brother is saving the sheets? Really, though?
Girl, it's rough out here in these streets, and whatever little bits that you can hold on to remember.
I mean, I know we got the Rona, but my goodness. That had me cracking up.
I was just thinking about like the thank you for that question, first of all, but I was thinking about the little details that remind us, like smells and the sound, like you know how it is, like you listen to a song and it can take you exactly right back to like your high school year when you were behind the bleachers with such and so, and like really specific moments that can be conjured up by tastes, by by all of the senses. And so just missing, just trying to visualize this man longing for and missing his lover, and he misses how she smells. So that was the sheet.
Oh, Lord. I mean, I got it. I totally got it. But I was like, he is hiding the sheets behind shelves and carrying on. I was like, what is going on? And then the moment where he realizes that that's what that they've been getting busy on them same sheets, that right there was like, because in that moment, the sheets represented two different things. For him, it represented the form of love, but for her, it represented like a rebirth of their relationship. You know, she was like, oh, I found these in the bin downstairs. I was like, oh, y'all are killing me. I was yelling at the screen, talking to the screen.
So a lot of what I drew from as relates to Sylvia wasn't necessarily my dad's military experience, but more so still the longing of that relationship with your father, right? Because there were circumstances that afterwards made it difficult for me and him to have a relationship. And so that was there for me. That was ready. That was available. I understood that longing, that deep longing for this man in your life.
As an African filmmaker who never got to see any kind of images of myself or my community growing up in general, much less any kind of intimacy or consensual intimacy. And I was like, I mean, that's revolutionary to be able to see a Black middle-aged woman being pleasured. I am here for that. That is what we're going to do. All of you need to sit there and just behold.
I was there for that too. So thank you, sister, because I was like, yes. What kind of preparation did you have to do dialect wise? Because it's a lot and they all sound different. And honey, the Africans will come for you if you don't do it right. They will come for you. They'll be like, no, sister. No, sister.
That's sad.
Like, we have to nail this dialect because really they wouldn't be, and they wouldn't be speaking English. They would be speaking their language. And so that was important to me. And when Manuel would show up, or the choreographer when he from Angola, when he would show up on set and give us the thumbs up or say that that sounded, that meant a lot because it felt like, okay, we're doing it justice. We're honoring these characters properly by getting this dialect down to a T.
Congratulations, Ekwa, on everything. I'm looking forward to talking to you many more times. This won't be the last time we have a conversation. And Miss Jamie, I'm hoping that I can grab you when you get ready to do the Batman with the Robert Pattinson when they start, talking about that. Tell your people you want to talk to me.
Right.
Call me.
Tell your people you want to talk to a sister. But no. Yeah, you guys, it was beautiful. And I thank you so much for taking time out of your morning to chat with me about it. I wish I'd had more time. There's so many more questions that
Thank you
I
so much.
Thank you, Carla. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.